February. February is a special month. Do you know why? It's a winter month, that's true. And where some of us live, we often have snow and ice in winter. That means fun. Fun in different ways. Fun in many different ways. In other places in our country in February, there isn't any snow or ice. The sun is bright and warm. In still other places, the weather is wet and rainy. But no matter what the weather is, or where you may live in this country, February is a special month. Let's look at the calendar to see why. How many days are there? Yes, February has only 28 days this year. Now, January had 31 days. And March, the month that comes after February, also has 31 days. April has 30 days. In fact, every month except February has either 30 days or 31 days. February has 28 days, except once every 4 years when it has 29 days. We call this leap year. But whether it has 29 days or 28 days, February is always the shortest month of the year. That's special, isn't it? Is there anything more that is special about February? Yes, it has 3 special days. One of these is February 12th. Do you know what is special about this day? It's the birthday of Abraham Lincoln. Do you know about February 14th? This is Valentine's Day, when we send Valentines to our friends. The third special day is February 22nd, the birthday of George Washington. Do you know who George Washington was? He was the first president of our country. He was born more than 200 years ago. Much of our country was wilderness when George Washington was a boy. There were not many schools in America then, so George could not go to school every day as you do. Still, he learned much by talking to people, such as this surveyor, and by watching people work. We can imagine how carefully he would watch. He wanted to learn as much as he could. He was very honest. Everyone liked him and trusted him. This is how he looked when he grew up. When he was a man, George Washington became a general in the army. He led our soldiers in the Revolutionary War, and he helped us to win our freedom. He was brave, a great leader, and his countrymen loved him. Then, after our freedom had been won, George Washington became our country's first president. The capital city of our country is named for our first president, Washington. In this city, you can see the Washington Monument, built to honor the man who is known as the father of our country. So his birthday, February 22nd, is a special day. Now, let's look at another special day. February 12th is Abraham Lincoln's birthday. Abraham Lincoln was born in a log cabin more than 100 years ago. When he was a boy, he read a great deal, after he had finished helping his mother and father with the day's work. When Abraham Lincoln grew up, he was friendly with everyone. and still he read whenever he could. He wanted to learn many things. People in the town where he lived liked him. He was one of the most honest young men they had known, and that's why they called him Honest Abe. They trusted him and respected him. Many years later, he was elected President of the United States. Today, people from all over the country visit a great monument to Abraham Lincoln in our nation's capital. His birthday is February 12th. Well, two of the special days in this month are birthdays of presidents of our country. But what about the third special day? February 14th. Valentine's Day. This is a happy time when we see many hearts, because on this day especially, we tell people we care about them. We give hearts to say we are giving our love and friendship. Give Valentines to our family. We send Valentines to friends and relatives who live far away. And we give them to our friends who live near us. This is a special day for telling people that we care about them. It'll be a busy, happy month as we learn and tell about the special days. Do you remember what day is George Washington's birth? Do you remember how he learned things when he was a boy? Could you tell why he is called the father of our country? Could you make a cabin like the one in which Abraham Lincoln was born? What day is his birthday? Do you remember how, as he grew up, Abraham Lincoln spent much of his time reading? Of course, you remember what day is Valentine's Day. And, of course, you know why this is one of the happiest days in February and in the whole year.